Hi, I'm Jens from Danfoss. This video is about how to work with a refrigerant slider, but we will use a case of comparing two refrigerants, like in a retrofit scenario, to highlight a few of the features of the refrigerant slider. You have installed the app and probably grouped it with all the other great apps from Danfoss Cooling, so we open the refrigerant slider. First, let's pull up the two refrigerants that we want to compare into favorites. First, R507, and at the same time we select it as the refrigerant we first want to check. You select the refrigerant by clicking the name of the refrigerant. But let's also add the potential new refrigerant, the R407F, to the favorites at the same go, as we will for sure be switching back and forth between the two refrigerants. If you have an Android phone, you just check the checkboxes to the right. We selected R507. R407F was just sent to the favorites. But before we go on, let's just have a look at the other settings. If you click on the sprocket wheel button, you can set your units, that's degree Celsius or degree Fahrenheit. You can switch between the GWP calculation method, that is the IPCC Assessment Report 4 or Assessment Report 5. If you work with the European F-gas regulation, you should follow the AR4. Finally, you can set your pressure units as well. Let's first enter the evaporating temperature of minus 10 degrees Celsius to see what the operating low pressure looks like. That's 3.44 bar. So let's compare with R407F. When we look at the list of refrigerants, you can see the R407F has been pulled up to the top of the favorites. So it's quite easy to switch between the two. You can see that the evaporation pressure is slightly higher with R407F, but it's so little that it doesn't make any practical difference. Now we've pulled up the two refrigerants up on the same screen so we can compare the numbers directly. Let's have a look at the GWP, and as you can see, there's a significant difference in the values where the older refrigerant is more than double the new. If we look at the evaporation pressure, they are almost the same with just an insignificant difference. If we look at the condensing pressure, the difference is larger, but still to the good side, so to speak. The R407F has a lower pressure at 30 degrees Celsius, so no need to do anything radical to the system. To check a couple of other properties, you click on the right arrow to get the second page. And if we look at the class, both are HFCs, safety groups are both A1, and finally the both works with POE oil. But although you can get a fairly good picture of the refrigerant comparison with the refrigerant slider, there are quite a few more things to think of in case of retrofitting. So you should also consult the HLOG P diagrams to check enthalpy, among other things. Be sure to check and adjust the superheat if you do go ahead with the retrofitting. And remember that it should be the dew point temperature that determine the basis for the new superheat setting. And finally, remember that a retrofit is not something you just do unless you're a professional. So please consult also the refrigerant manufacturers for compatibility, especially when it comes to oil. Thank you for listening in on this quick walkthrough of the Danfoss refrigerant slider. And if you haven't already downloaded the app, please follow the link in the text under this video. Thank you.